There is one vital lesson which you must remember when laying booby traps yourself, and that is, tell everybody who is at all likely to come in contact with your trap where and what type of trap you have laid. The enemy are a sufficient danger to our men without any addition from you.
I say to hats. H-A-T-S. Not rats. We've got dozens of those up here. What?
Oh. Morning, sir.
Morning.
We've laid that booby trap, sir, on the trek leading down to the ford, just north of the village, sir.
There, sir.
Ah, good.
You can let the CRE know immediately.
Shall I phone it through, sir?
Not on your life, Sergeant Major. This information is secret. I'll write a message.
Warned DR, Jackson. See the other sections are told. And you there, better nip across the brigade headquarters. Let them know.
Very good, sir.
And for God's sake, get your hair cut.
Yes, sir.
Everyone concerned will hear about it very soon. The people to be warned are the HQ staff through the CRE, and most important, local troops and other sections of the unit engaged on the work. If you do not warn them, our own troops may all unconsciously walk into the trap you have set for the enemy. And your carelessness will not only result in casualties to our own men, but may give valuable information to the enemy about the movements of our forces. This is the result of failing to report a trap. Forewarned is forearmed. Another thing to remember is the principle of double bluff. That is, a dummy booby trap, which the enemy will see, and a real one which he will explode when dismantling the dummy. These sappers have planted a very obvious tripwire across the trench, which the enemy will be certain to find and take to pieces. But to do so, he will have to tread on the duckboard underneath, which, as you can see, is being made all ready to give a rousing welcome to any visitor. Now to see how anything recently in the enemy's possession should not be dealt with. These enemy troops are taking no precautions at all. There may be traps all around them. There is no attempt at investigation, no caution, no suspicion of anything that may be a potential danger. Their carelessness will bring its own reward. You can only make one mistake, as these men have learned too late. Here you see an experienced party of infantry preparing to examine a trench recently captured from the enemy. Between them they carry wire cutters, a prismatic compass for detecting buried shells or grenades, chalk, scissors, rope for pulling suspicious objects from a distance, buckets of water for drenching, torches, probing bars, and pins, which are useful for making safe any mechanisms found. Mines and traps are very difficult to detect, and therefore, during an advance, everything must be systematically examined. Searching for booby traps is the responsibility of all armed. The rendering safe of all traps or suspected traps is the responsibility of the sapper. Be suspicious of everything you find, even though you find most of them to be false alarms or red herrings. Someone's life, it may be your own, depends on the care with which you make your search. The most innocent looking things may be proved guilty if you examine them carefully enough. And remember to mark everything you examine to let others know. The enemy engineers are counting on your carelessness. Your own comrades are relying on your vigilance. Having got the booby trap mentality firmly embedded, you must always be on the lookout for traps. If you find any, and if you're not a sapper, drench them with water, fence off, and mark them clearly. Then send for someone who knows how to deal with them. Even false booby traps can be most effective in holding up and delaying the enemy. Here is something suspicious which attracts the attention of the NCO. A new trench board, which may quite possibly conceal a trap. This particular trap is very easy to make and very difficult to detect. The NCO has made the reasonably safe assumption, based on the fact that the enemy had very recently left the trench, that the charge will be a small one, and that it will be safe to spring the trap and not worry the sappers about it. A sharp pull from behind cover, and the trap is blown quite harmlessly with no loss of life and very little trouble. Here, a party of sappers are carrying out an examination in a house recently occupied by enemy troops. Everything must be examined minutely. Nothing overlooked, for traps may be found anywhere, set to be fired in a dozen different ways, and it may be depended upon that in every case, concealment will be absolute. You have to look for booby traps, and where you can't look, you must feel. Suspect everything until you know it's all right. Get this suspicious outlook firmly in your mind and be nasty yourself. Nothing reduces morale quicker than the uncertainty as to whether anything can safely be moved or any attractive souvenir picked up. Everything movable must be carefully examined by probing wires or thin knife blades with the minimum of movement. Remember that the enemy may be using mechanisms with which you're not familiar, and that traps may be set in places you would thought impossible. Don't underestimate your enemy. Remember, too, that there are such things as delayed action mechanisms which go off after a certain time. Look out for them. They can be most unpleasant unless discovered and disposed of promptly. And don't imagine just because you wouldn't have set a trap in a certain place that the enemy wouldn't either. As a matter of fact, those are the very places he's most likely to choose. There are no set rules for hiding traps. They may be anywhere.
Hey, Corp, there's one here been fiddled
with. Uh-huh. Somebody seems to have found something. Yes, an enemy trap in position. Great care must be taken to move nothing until the mechanism has been located and a safety pin inserted. The good sapper carries a supply of these pins when searching for booby traps. Never move mechanisms until they're neutralized, as they may work either by pressure or the release of pressure. Once the safety pin is in position and secured so that it cannot fall out, all wires or cords can be cut and the mechanism and charge made accessible for dismantling. Once you can see the trap, you'll have some idea of how it works and what precautions to take. But even then, be careful. For remember, it may be a dummy which in turn will explode a real one. Having removed the charge and mechanism, put them in water as soon as possible. And then, go on searching. For the trap you've found may be one of many. Never become careless, even for 1 second.
We don't know it.
Oh, that boy, eh?
Dear, dear. A pity. Remember? Forewarned is forearmed. you can only make one mistake.